Hello everyone. So here in this problem, we have to evaluate limit x tends to 3, x cube minus 7x square plus 15x minus 9 whole upon x raised to 4 minus 5x cube plus 27x minus 27. Now, before starting with the solution, let's observe the given function. So here the given function is algebraic function. And whenever we have algebraic function, then we start with direct method. And if direct method fails, then we look for some other method. So let's start the solution with direct method. So for that, I will assume this given limit as L. So let L equal to limit x tends to 3, x cube minus 7x square plus 15x minus 9 whole upon x raised to 4 minus 5x cube plus 27x minus 27. Now, by direct method, we will substitute this value 3 in the given function. So here we will get 3 cube minus 7 into 3 square plus 15 into 3 minus 9 whole upon 3 raised to 4 minus 5 into 3 cube plus 27 into 3 minus 27. Now let's solve this. So 3 cube is 27, 3 square that is 9, and 9 sevens are 63, so minus 63, plus 15 threes are 45 minus 9 whole upon, now 3 raised to 4 that is 81 minus 3 cube that is 27, and 27 into 5 that is 135. Next, 27 into 3, again we have 81 minus 27. And if we'll do the addition in the numerator, we will get 0. And in the denominator, again, we will get 0. So it means we are getting 0 upon 0, which we call as indeterminate form. So whenever we get indeterminate form by direct method, we say direct method fails. So here, direct method fails. So in that case, we search for other method to evaluate the limit. Now, if you'll observe the given limit, then here in the numerator we have x cube minus 7x square plus 15x minus 9, and in the denominator we have x raised to 4 minus 5x cube plus 27x minus 27. So we have polynomials in numerator as well as in denominator. So we will find out the factors of these polynomials, and we'll check whether we can cancel the factors from numerator and denominator to get our answer. Now, the power of the polynomial in the numerator is 3 and the power in the denominator is 4. So, the degree is 4 in the denominator and degree is 3 in the numerator. So, in such cases, to get the factors by using the direct formula is not that easy. Hence, here we will use synthetic division to find out the factors of the given polynomials. So, by synthetic division, here this first term, that is x cube minus 7x square plus 15x minus 9, here we can write down this term in synthetic division as 1, that is coefficient of x cube, minus 7, that is coefficient of x square, then 15, that is coefficient of x, and in the end we will write down the constant, that is minus 9. So whenever we use synthetic division, that time we write down the coefficients in the first row. Then the factor which is possible, we write down that factor here on the left hand side of this vertical line. So here, since x tends to 3, and we know that in the method of factorization we get the opposite factor, that is x minus 3. So this could be the factor that we are gonna get in numerator as well as in the denominator. Hence here I'll say, let's the first root is 3. Now if I'll keep this 3, then by synthetic division here I'll get 1. So we are copying this first number as it is, then we'll multiply this number 3 with this number 1. So 3 into 1, again 3. Then we'll add, then minus 7 plus 3 will give us minus 4. Again we'll do the multiplication. So this will become 3 into minus 4, which will give us minus 12. So that will become 15 plus minus 12, and we will get 3. Next, 3 into 3 will get 9, and minus 9 plus 9 is 0. So whenever we get 0 in the last column, we say that the given number is the root of this equation. So we got one root as 3. So we will rewrite this as the first root that we got 3. So here we'll write x minus 3 as the first bracket, and the second bracket is nothing but the terms that are remaining. So here we'll multiply this first term by constant 1, then we'll multiply this term by x, and we'll multiply this term by x square. So we will get 1 into x square, that is x square, minus 4 into x, that is minus 4x, and 3 into 1, that is 3. So this is the factor that we got for x cube minus 7x square plus 15x minus 9. Now similarly, we can find out the factor for this second equation. Now the next equation is x raised to 4 minus 5x cube plus 27x minus 27. Now for this we'll do synthetic division. So the coefficient of x raised to 4 is 1, coefficient of x cube is minus 5. Now be careful, here we don't have x raised to 2 term, so the coefficient of x raised to 2 is 0. Next, coefficient of x is 27, and the constant term is minus 27. So again we'll perform the same process. So here we'll require one root. Now since we are taking 3 as a root in the numerator, so same root can come in the denominator since we have limit x tends to 3. So here I am taking 3. Now let's perform. 1, I'll copy it down here as it is. 3 into 1 multiplication is 3. Then addition, minus 5 plus 3 will give us minus 2. Then 3 into minus 2 is minus 6. 0 plus minus 6 is minus 6. Again minus 6 multiplied by 3, that is minus 18. So 27 minus 18 will get 9. And 9 into 3 is again 27. And here we will get 0. So we got first root as 3. So first bracket is x minus 3. And same process we'll do, we'll multiply this term by 1, this term by x, this term by x square, and this term by x cube. So we will get here as x cube, this will become minus 2x square, this will become minus 6x, and this will become plus 9. So we got these factors for denominator. Now again, the second term is cubic equation, and for that cubic equation to find out the roots, we will again apply the synthetic division. So now that x cube minus 2x square minus 6x plus 9 will give us the term by the method of synthetic division. So here I am rewriting it as 1, that is coefficient of x cube, minus 2 coefficient of x square, minus 6 and 9. Here again I will use the root as 3. Now I am copying this first number as it is. Next multiplication, 3 into 1, that is 3. So minus 2 plus 3 is 1. Again 1 into 3 is 3. So minus 6 plus 3 is minus 3. Minus 3 into 3 is minus 9, and the addition is 0. So again I got one root as 3. So here I will write x minus 3 as first bracket, and second bracket will be, this term will be multiplied by x square, this term will be multiplied by x. So we will get x square plus x minus 3. So we got these factors for x cube minus 2x square minus 6x plus 9, which we will substitute here. So this term will become x minus 3, the first bracket as it is, and the second bracket will become x minus 3 x square plus x minus 3. And now we will substitute these two values in the given limit. So therefore the limit L will become limit x tends to 3, numerator is x minus 3 x raised to 4, I mean x raised to 2, minus 4x plus 3 upon x minus 3 x minus 3 and x square plus x minus 3. Now if you will observe, then we can cancel the factor x minus 3 from both numerator and denominator. Next, in the numerator we have one quadratic equation, as well as in the denominator we have quadratic equation. So we will find out the factors of the quadratic equation. So in numerator we have the last term as 3, and for 3 we have the factors minus 3 minus 1. So the multiplication of these two terms is 3, whereas the addition of minus 3 and minus 1 is minus 4. So here we will get limit x tends to 3, x minus 3 and x minus 1 in the numerator. In the denominator we have x minus 3 and if we will try to find out the factors for minus 3, we will not get so easily. So I will keep this term x square plus x minus 3 as it is. Now if you will observe, again we can cancel this x minus 3 and x minus 3 from numerator as well as from denominator. So I will rewrite the remaining terms. So we have x minus 1 and x square plus x minus 3 in the denominator. And for this we will again apply direct method. So therefore by direct method we will get 3 minus 1 in the numerator, and here 3 square plus 3 minus 3 in the denominator. So 3 minus 1 is 2, plus 3 and minus 3 cancel, and 3 square is 9, and hence the value of the given limit is 2 upon 9. Thank you.